and I want this to be interactive, so let me start, let me tell me what a legacy is. This is another thing, no matter where you go in the country. All of a sudden, I'm speaking like English as a second language. Nobody understands the question? And then there we go. Something you leave behind, right? That's a legacy. For your age group, I like to use the term brand. Coca-Cola, where I'm from, is headquartered in Atlanta. Coca-Cola versus Pepsi are two unique brands in the cola marketplace, and almost everybody loves to drink a soft drink. And if you love Coca-Cola and you've been to Taco Bell, you probably know you can't get a Coke product. But if you love a cola enough, you'll drink a Pepsi. Two distinct brands. The great thing is I look upon you here, everybody in this room but me has an association with Manhattan College in some form or another. And now I do, so I'm honored to have that. But at some point, men's basketball has a different brand than girls' volleyball. And they're not nearly as good looking either. Lacrosse is different. You have a different brand than Fordham or Iona. And then at some point, all of you have your own unique brand. You have to take the opportunity that you've been presented to student athletes here and get that degree. I know everybody's not a full-ride athlete on all the sports. I know there's walk-ons, but I'm going to bet there's tutoring help or some study hall help. Some added benefits you get as a student athlete with all the time you put in representing this university, you've got to get your degree. It became so important in Phillip's life, and I'm going to tell you about that in a few minutes. Take advantage of the opportunities. So my son never went to prom in high school, but he went to prom as a freshman at Auburn University, already been on national television, already caught the first two of his career touchdowns, which is the career record holder for touchdowns by a tight end Auburn, and took this special girl to prom. One thing I've learned through this journey, Philip did amazingly, he told people he loved him. And it wasn't always romantic, and it wasn't sexual. Casey and Philip didn't hold hands as much as she tried to. But he did something, and there's a word for it. And you will find in this curriculum that we hope you're going to use a word by Patrick and Tiffany Moody. And as a father who's at the time 20 years old, if somebody wants to tell you that your son was available, is a pretty powerful word. Think about that. We had already had a list of words to create this curriculum, and available wasn't on it. Are you available? 20-year-old male was told he was available. Because Philip had built the platform. Philip may have a little bit of an advantage over you because he was on national TV in this crazy Southern football environment, but all of you are creating a platform each and every day. Your student athletes, are you available? My son was 6'4", 255, and played in the SEC, played in the NFL. It didn't matter his size, he had a tender heart. He took his platform that was partially given to him, then he enhanced and learned and grew. And it didn't take a lot of time, didn't take talent, didn't take a treasure, it took a tender heart to want to be able to give to someone else. I encourage you to find somebody on this campus that you've been walking past if you're a senior for 4 years and you don't have anything in common other than you go to the same school, and yet you've never held a door for them, or smiled at them, or fist bumped them, or simply said hi. That's tithing. That's how you give back. To me, tithing is putting a dunk on somebody and celebrating with your team, not taunting the opponent. It's walking up to a professor that you have and saying, I hope you have a great day in the classroom. If they don't, maybe you fib a little bit afterwards and tell them they had a great day anyway. It's a student athlete that's sitting up in the front row. To me, that's all the version of tithing. It's taking your talents and using them to make somebody else smile, make somebody else feel good about themselves. There is simply no discrimination when you have a series of poor decisions and compressed time frame. It took my son's life, and he did wonderful things for people throughout his life. He was one of these people that very rarely had a bad day. He could find the good in almost anything, and it took his life. And I purely believe it's because he was willing to be a good friend. If you remember Steve Mark's quote is, be so good they can't ignore you, I'm going to challenge you to be so great you can be counted on.